Hi students, in our previous video we had discussed about the Illingham diagram. Now in this video we are going to continue with the Illingham diagram application. Where are we going to use this Illingham diagram? Is our main application. Now we know we are using the materials that are made up of iron in our day-to-day life. This iron is also present in the earth crust in many of its ores. Two of the ores we are choosing as our source to obtain the iron. The ores that we had chosen as the source of iron are named as hematite, whose formula is Fe2O3, and magnetite, whose formula is Fe3O4. What are the two ores we are using, children? Hematite, its formula is Fe2O3. Magnetite, its formula is Fe3O4. These are the ores of iron chosen for the extraction of iron. But we know it may be hematite or magnetite. We have learned in Illingham diagram that the iron is combined with only one oxygen. It formed the FeO. It formed the FeO. In the Illingham diagram, we had learned that in the formation of FeO, it had used the delta G free energy of minus 341. But when we are applying, which one we are applying? We are applying that iron oxide when reacted with coke. It is going to form iron plus carbon monoxide. Do you remember these two reactions? It is a combination of two reactions. This can happen at what temperature? Means you can observe the line is at a higher delta G negative value when compared with coke that is present at this line and the coke that is at very lower line. In the previous video we have learned above the 1400 degrees Celsius, that is 1673 Kelvin, above 1673 Kelvin, the line of coke is very lower to the line of FeO. Hence, coke can reduce iron oxide. Coke can reduce iron oxide into metallic iron, and itself it will undergo oxidation of forming carbon monoxide. Is our previous concept that we have discussed. From this Illingham diagram, presently what we are concluding is, in order to extract the iron from its oxide, we need the highest temperature above 1673 Kelvin. Above this temperature only, this process takes place. In order to withhold this high temperature, we are going to use a furnace called blast furnace. What are we calling this one as? The blast furnace. This entire diagrammatic name, it is called as the blast furnace. We have introduced about the furnace. It is the device in which it can hold a very high temperature. Blast furnace is used in the extraction of iron. In this blast furnace, we are having many zones. So let us first reaction side, and what are we going to call that zone is also mentioned at the right side. So presently, when I am working, first your task is to listen, and after completing of my explanation, once again you must practice this diagram from the NCERT textbook along with equations that are present in the different zones. Diagram they will not question anywhere, but they will question what are the reactions that are taking place in that particular zone. So let us start. The main salient feature of blast furnace. What is the main purpose of blast furnace? It is used in the metallurgy for the extraction of iron from its ore. What are the ores of iron we have discussed? We have discussed the ores of iron are hematite Fe2O3 and magnetite Fe3O4. These ores of iron are fed into the chamber. This is the largest chamber, this one, they are fed into this chamber. This part by which the ore is fed, it is called as the hooper. This part we call as the hooper. H-O-O-P-R, hooper. Into the hooper, the ores of iron are introduced. Along with the ores of iron, we are able to introduce one more compound that is called limestone. Do you know the formula of limestone? Yes, calcium carbonate. What is that one? Calcium carbonate. What is the need of calcium carbonate here? Means, in the ore of iron, there is one impurity that is called silica. What is the impurity that is present in the iron ore? Silica. What is the formula of silica? SiO2. This silica need to be removed before we get our metal in a molten state. What need to be removed? Silica need to be removed before we get our metal in a molten state. And in order to remove this silica, SiO2, we are adding limestone, that is calcium carbonate. At a particular temperature, that is around 500 to 800 Kelvin in between, the calcium carbonate, once it was introduced to the hooper, ore and the calcium carbonate we are introducing. Along with calcium carbonate, we are introducing the coke. What is the purpose of coke? The purpose of coke is to reduce iron oxide into iron. Coke purpose is to reduce iron oxide into iron. At what temperature does this coke will reduce iron oxide into iron? It can reduce the above temperature, that is 1673 Kelvin. So let us see here. There are many zones we mentioned in the blast furnace. When we come from the top, we can come across the zones like at 500 to 800 Kelvin. Means at this temperature, 500 to 800 Kelvin. It is called zone of reduction. The temperature is called zone of reduction. Here, reduction means, what is meant by reduction means? Removal of some oxygen. It is called reduction. In this case, how the oxygen is going to be removed? It is not going to remove oxygen from iron oxide, FeO, with the help of coke. But the oxygen will be removed from the ore, that is hematite. That is hematite. With the carbon monoxide, we may have a doubt now. Where did we got this carbon monoxide? I didn't introduce anywhere carbon monoxide here. But what did we introduce? We introduced the ore, limestone and coke. So let us come here. The ore that is called hematite, Fe2O. on the reactant side. Once you introduce the reducing reagent carbon monoxide, one of the oxygen is going to be removed from this one. Out of 9, if you remove 1, what will be the number of oxygens remaining? 8. So we are having it in a reduced form of Fe3O4. What is this reduced form? Fe3O4. So this carbon monoxide is gaining one oxygen from the hematite, and it is converting. Hematite is converting into the another ore that is called Fe3O4. What is the name of the Fe3O4 we call? Magnetite. What is this one? Magnetite. It is very easy to reduce the magnetite into FeO. So, first hematite is reduced to magnetite. In this magnetite, we have the formula Fe3O4. This is a mixed ore. Generally, it will be formed by Fe2O3 and one molecule of FeO. But together, we write this one as the Fe3O4. We can find Fe3O4. There are 3 iodides and 4 oxygens. If one oxygen is removed, how to remove an oxygen? An oxygen can be removed by an reducing reagent. But here we are using the reducing reagent, carbon monoxide. When reacting with carbon monoxide, Fe3O4 when lost an oxygen, it is going to convert into 3 moles of FeO. 3 moles of FeO. And also it is forming carbon dioxide. It is observed what are the things taking place in this zone. Hematite is converted into magnetite. Magnetite is converted into FeO, that is iron 2 oxide. Here in all these cases, the ores of iron had undergone reduction. So this is called as zone of reduction. Now let us take the point, where did we got this carbon monoxide? When we feed the hooper with bore, limestone and coke, the coke will be reaching to the bottom. Of the blast furnace. At the bottom of the blast furnace, we are supplying blast of air and oxygen. What are we supplying? Blast of air and oxygen. At the temperature around 2170 Kelvin. At a very high temperature. The coke that we have passed through the hooper, it will undergo combustion. Combustion is the process in which the reactants will be reacting with oxygen to give a product by releasing lot amount of heat. So this coke that we have added is reacting with oxygen. Where did we got this oxygen? By the inputs here, we had a blast of air and oxygen. This oxygen is reacting with the coke at this highest temperature to form carbon dioxide. Some coke molecules were forming the carbon dioxide, and some of the coke molecules are reducing the FeO into Fe. This is what we got. Some of the coke molecules are reducing FeO into Fe. So some particles are forming carbon dioxide and remaining particles of coke are reducing the iron oxide to iron. But here the main point is, in order to reduce our iron oxide to iron, we need the highest temperature we mentioned. So this highest temperature is the zone of combustion. That is forming the highest temperature. We can observe it is around 1570 Kelvin to 2170 Kelvin. In the blast furnace, the highest temperature ranges from 1570 Kelvin to 2170 Kelvin. At this point, we are having the process of burning of coal. That is called zone of combustion. Means we can reduce our iron oxide at 1673 Kelvin dimension. That we are doing here. Now we came to know two zones. What is the lowest temperature zone? That is zone of reduction. It is reducing carbon monoxide, is reducing the ores of iron into the magnetite form. And we had already came to know about zone of combustion. It is at its highest temperature. And in the middle, we got a zone that is evolving at 900 to 1500 Kelvin. In this zone, there are different reactions. What are the different reactions? The coke that we had added is reacting with carbon monoxide. Carbon dioxide to form carbon monoxide. What is happening here? The formation of carbon monoxide takes place. So the carbon monoxide that had formed at this zone will be moving to the higher zone. And in this higher zone, once we had inputted ore, there the reduction process takes place. So observation length, the coke molecules that are left behind, few more, they are reacting with carbon dioxide to form carbon monoxide. This carbon monoxide is used for the reduction of ores of iron and also for the reduction of even FeO. So here we can understand that it is also involved in removing oxygen from the FeO. So this is also called as zone of reduction. But in the starting I mentioned, in the blast furnace, there is extraction of iron. There is an impurity. What is an impurity? It is silica. Silica formula is SiO2. How to remove this silica? This silica can be removed by adding calcium oxide. But we don't add calcium oxide directly here. We are adding that in the form of limestone. This limestone is decomposing at the lower temperature of 500 to 800 Kelvin to form CaO plus CO2. Here, that is at 900 to 1500 Kelvin. At the temperature itself, the CaO that had formed will react with the impurity, that is silica, forming in the form of a slag. See, the calcium oxide will react with silica in the formation of a slag. Slag is the molten state of the impurity. Means that impurity, there is silica, SiO2, when we have calcium oxide, that will be converted in the form of the liquid, molten form. And that is removed with the combination of CaO. So, how is the silica removed in the case of blast furnace? Silica is removed in the case of blast furnace by addition of limestone, which is in the form of which decomposes to CaO, forming silica slag. That was removed. Please observe, at here the reaction starts. What is the first reaction taking place here? Burning of coke. The coke is oxidized to carbon dioxide. Not all coke particles will be completely oxidized to carbon dioxide. Some will undergo oxidation, that is combustion. And some of the coke particles are reducing iron oxide. Next one, the coke comes here. The coke will react carbon dioxide to form carbon monoxide. And at this zone, the carbon monoxide particles will reduce the iron oxide. And still the remaining unreacted carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide, they will be exhausted in the form of gases. That is carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide. This is the explanation for the blast furnace. Now our point out is, the impurity is removed at this zone in the form of molten slag. In the form of the molten slag. And our pure iron, we cannot say pure iron, the molten iron. The molten iron is collected at the bottom. Molten iron is collected at the bottom. In this form, which form the iron, we are able to extract in the blast furnace. So, our conclusion is, what is the purpose of blast furnace? The purpose of blast furnace is to reduce, is to get our iron ore in the molten form. Iron from its ore in the molten form. We had done this one in the blast furnace. What are the various zones we had? Zone of combustion, slag formation, and zone of reduction. These are the four main zones that are present in the blast furnace. And in the upcoming video, I will give you the data for this one. That is the notes writing we can see. Or here itself we can continue to observe these four in a short method of notes. For the examination point of view, we want the zones, the reactions that are happening in the zones. So what is the application of Willingham diagram, children? The application of Willingham diagram is to know at what temperature the iron oxide can be reduced. In the blast furnace, we had obtained the molten iron at the last. This molten iron contains the 4% of carbon in it. If the percentage of carbon is more, the iron is not strong. Its percentage need to be decreased. That is, carbon percentage need to be decreased. So, this so-called iron that we got in the form of molten state in the blast furnace, that is having 4% of carbon, it is known as the pig iron. What are we calling this one as the pig iron? Now, in this molten iron, that is called as pig iron, there are some impurities. There are some impurities. The pig iron is percentage of carbon must be removed, and the impurities that are present in this pig iron must also be removed before we are getting our purest form of iron. Now we have a question. What is the iron that we are using in our day-to-day life? The commercial iron that we are using in our day-to-day life, it is called as the malleable iron. What is this one called as the malleable iron? What is malleable iron that can be beaten into thin sheets? Here, this malleable iron is also called as the wrought iron. WROGHT. Wrought iron. Now, our concept is to get this malleable iron or wrought iron from the pig iron. The commercial iron that we are using, that is the purest form of iron. But what did we mention? The slag that was removed, the silica is removed. Along, after removing the silica, in the form of silica slag, our pig iron got some impurities. What are the impurities that are present in the pig iron? Means you can see the impurities like sulfur, phosphorus, silicon, manganese were all some of the impurities present in the pig iron. This pig iron is just used for casting various are not strong. They are not strong because it is having 4% of carbon. How much of percentage of carbon? 4% of carbon. Now we want to reduce the carbon percentage. And now we are going to take up this pig iron and we are going to melt it with the scrap iron and coal. With the scrap iron and coal. So when we melt pig iron with the scrap iron and coal using hot air blast, it is converted into the iron that is having only 3% of carbon. We call 3% of carbon as our cast iron. It is extremely hard, but it is brittle, easy to break, because it is having 3% of carbon. Along with that, it will have some impurities. Now, when we go on taking these cast iron, that is the impurities that are present in cast iron will be oxidized, that means they are removed in the form of the oxides. In another furnace, that is called reverberating furnace. At last, we get our wrought iron or malleable iron. Because we are coating our reverberating furnace with hematite. What is the formula of hematite? Fe2O3. Hematite formula is Fe2O3. This hematite, when we add, it is going to remove the coke. That is still left behind, all the excess of carbon present here. See, if I say I am using the 3 moles of coke, if I had lined up a reverberating furnace with the hematite, it is going to remove the excess of carbon, most percentage of carbon. And we are getting that one in the form of carbon monoxide removed. We have our purest form of the iron, that is called as the wrought iron. So what is the purpose of coating reverberating furnace with hematite? Means to remove the excess of carbon and to reduce the percentage of carbon in the iron. That is the malleable iron. There also percentage of carbon will be very less, not more, when compared with the cast iron and the pig iron. So what are the three kinds of irons we got? In the blast furnace we got pig iron, which is having 4% of carbon. That was again converted to cast iron, having 3% of carbon. And last, our purest form of iron is